They were formed just this year. Is that true, Pastor? Yes. Yes, E12, their first Christmas performance together as a group will be this year. They're going to be involving some musical acts as well as a lot of props. And it's going to show us a really moving and sad reality about the human condition. Are we ready? You guys can take off the props. You guys can take it off. Take it off. Yes, please come inside. Take your seats. Ladies and gentlemen, how are you liking the first half so far? Now, Jeff is on an extended bathroom break, so he won't be with us tonight. But I got to ask you, who's a better host, me or Jeff? If you think it's me, make some noise. Okay, if you think if it's Jeff, make some noise. You know, because I'm speaking English, and I thought the English speakers would cheer me on, because I'm the English MC. So one more time, if you think I'm the better MC, make some noise. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you. So this performance, like I said, is going to be moving. It's going to be filled with emotion. And I believe they actually pre-recorded all the instrumentals. So they actually went to a professional studio, and they pre-recorded all the instrumentals. And it sounds like, it sounds just like a song. It sounds so professional. So the two leaders for E12 are Victor and Karen Santos. You know, they're very special people. I remember Victor always has a nice smile on his face. And Karen, I don't know too well, but I see that she seems to always have a joyous attitude. Yeah, and I think it's really cool how they become leaders recently, and they get to show off, you know, the hard work it takes to be a leader. You know, I've been experimenting with positions of leadership myself, and I know that it's definitely much more difficult than I had ever anticipated. And I develop a new respect for my own leaders as well as people who take the challenge of leading sheep and leading people to get closer to Christ. So for the rest of the performance, for the second half, because we've just ended intermission, we have 7 performances left, so please bear with us. Like we mentioned earlier on, there are, you know, 3 or 4 key groups that you should look out for, including, you know, E2 and K10, and apparently we have a dark horse. Are we ready? E12 is ready? Okay. It looks like E12 is ready. And so, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Please enjoy the show and welcome E12.
Your enemy, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour. The thief comes only to steal, kill, and destroy.
There's something inside me that pulls beneath the surface, consuming, confusing. This lack of self-control I fear is never-ending, controlling. I can't seem to find myself again. My walls are closing in.
Without a sense of confidence, I'm convinced that there's just too much pressure to take.
I felt this way before, so insecure.
Crawling in my skin, these wounds, they will not heal. Fear is how I fall, confusing what is real.
Discomfort endlessly has pulled itself upon me, distracting, reacting. Against my will, I stand beside my own reflection. It's haunting, I can't seem to find myself again. My walls are closing in.
Absence of confidence, I'm convinced that there's just too much pressure to take.
I felt this way before, so insecure.
Crawling in my skin, these wounds, they will not heal. Fear is how I fall, confusing what is real. Crawling in my skin, these wounds,
resist him, standing firm in the faith, because you know that the family of believers throughout the world is undergoing the same kind of suffering.
Wide awake while the world is sound asleep, and too afraid of what might show up while you're dreaming. Nobody, nobody, nobody sees you. Nobody, nobody will believe you. And every day you try to pick up all the pieces, all the memories that somehow never leave you. Nobody, nobody, nobody sees you. Nobody, nobody will believe you.
God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. God only knows how it's killing you. But there's a kind of love that God only knows.
God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. But God only knows the real you. There's a kind of love that God only knows.
Misunderstood and the ones to blame. What if we could start over? We could start over. We could start over.
Oh, for the lonely, for the ashamed, the misunderstood and the ones to blame. What if we could start over? We could start over. We could start over. Kind of love that God only knows.
God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. But God only knows the real you. There's a kind of love that God only knows. God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. But God only knows the real you. There's a kind of love.
There's a kind of love that God only knows.
I have come that you may have life and have it to the full.
Thank you very much, E12. May I have Victor and Lois come as our interviewees. Victor and Lois. You know, I had seen that performance before, and I was talking to Victor about what that was about. You know, he talked about very serious issues, including depression and the human condition being very difficult at times. And people they want to hide, they want to run away. They don't want to be honest, but the reality is that God knows what you've been through. And I think it was really cool to see that moment when she was holding onto her chain so tightly, but eventually she was able to let go through the grace of God. This is a very difficult topic, and it's a challenge to be able to combat that. So it definitely tugged at my heartstrings. Go ahead. Please come to the stage. So there is a difficult topic being discussed here, and the main character seems like she's very sad and confused and depressed. Could you talk about that?
Initial topic was supposed to be suicide, but we were thinking about the kids down here, and we couldn't like envision how to kind of personify the, or perform the topic of suicide, so we just went with depression. Eventually, depression leads to other things anyway.
So the instruments in the beginning, now was that actual playing or was that pre-recorded?
Well, you were supposed to say that.
Yes, it was live music. It was 100% live music. So whose idea was it to get those big cardboard boxes? And it was so adorable to see your kids move them around and create the images on the screen. Who came up with that?
It was actually Karen. Karen was, YouTubing and trying to figure out like what the kids can do. And we saw the boxes, and then we just thought of putting it together, like a portrait of Jesus, like the footprints. And then, yeah.
And they're really beautiful. Who ended up making them?
I did.
So in the beginning, there was a bit of narration about some scripture being read. Who read that scripture?
Lois did.
It was really cute, Lois. I think you did a great job. Thank you so much. So one scene that really impacted me was the chains. And in a struggle, she rips through the chain, or she takes them off. Could you explain what those chains mean?
Well, the chain is basically our struggles and our past also, and how sometimes when we're down, the devil just keeps kicking us down, and then we kind of thought about, like, the chain kind of signifies when you actually choose Jesus or God, and then when you think that you're out of the pit, and then all of a sudden you're back in the pit, like your old bad habits coming, and, you know, it's just hard to shake off, and, you know, really, we do our part, and then Jesus does really take the rest. So,
you know, this is a very difficult topic, and I can't even begin to imagine how you started planning for it and what you're going to use in your performance to show, you know, depression and loneliness and things like that. How was that planning process like?
I was actually getting depressed myself. It was depressing because this year is our first year being leaders, and the thought of being a leader seemed a little easy. But as we actually, got through the process, especially our Christmas performance, it was by far probably one of the most difficult thing that we've had to gone through. I mean, the performance itself, as you can see, is not that, it's not that great, but just going through the process of getting people together with their life, it's just hard, very hard, very hard year.
You know, I'm sure it must have been really difficult for you, your group, and there must have been a lot of difficulty finding time and working together, but do you feel like you guys are more unified because of it? You guys are closer now?
Yeah, most definitely. There was a couple times where I was going to actually text a pastor and say, I think it's done. I'm done. This is it. I'm done. I give it a try, and, I think it's done. But, like I said, going through the process kind of is a refining moment. And I think every single one of us, including the members, are being refined in the process, so it's not easy for anyone.
Lois, do you think you can answer one question? What is your favorite thing about your dad?
He loves me.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Give a round of applause, please, for E12. You mentioned early on that they are a dark horse group. That means that they've been overlooked and they have not been in the best form the last 5 years. I don't think they've placed at all in the last 10 years. They've come back with a vengeance and they think that they really have a shot. And I've personally witnessed them working so hard and so long. In fact, this performance they made was originally 17 minutes long, fully, everything done. But then they learned that it's a 7-minute rule is going to be strictly enforced. So they started to slowly cut it down from 17 to 16 to 15. They brought it down to 14 minutes and they said, that's it. We can't cut it down anymore. But then they didn't want to lose. They thought they had a shot at winning. So they decided we're going to cut it a little bit more. They cut it down to, I think, 12 minutes. And they said, if we cut any more, no one's going to understand anything. It's too much. And they said, you know what? It's okay. We may not place, but you know, we'll show them everything we prepared. And then Jeff thought, I want to place. So he decided that 12 minutes was too much because if it's 12 minutes, that's 5 minutes over. And every minute you're over, you get a 5-point deduction. That would have been 25 points. So he couldn't have that. So it went from 12 minutes to 10 minutes to 9 minutes to 8 minutes and exactly 7 minutes on the dot. And they've made it. And it's gonna, they've taken a 17-minute performance. They've shrunk it together. What you're going to see is an interesting story about a common Christian experience of someone who is so into the world and goes through this process, whether it's through someone else or through a different Christian. They come to know Jesus, you know, whether it's encounter like I've experienced or anything else. And this story is going to show us exactly what that's about, you know. And if you guys don't know about K-12, on average, their average age is 112. They're old ladies who have no ability to do much. So if you look, the previous year performances, you know, they would do little dances and stuff with the younger people in front, but they couldn't really do much. They tried really hard one year with their their fan dance, which is a traditional fan dance, which was cool, but it didn't place. And now this year, they have some young blood, some young talent, and they're going to really shake things up. And I think that considering how much adversity they've gone through this year and how they tried hard to place but they couldn't the last 10 years, they're coming back with a vengeance and they're coming back strong. And as soon as they're ready, we're just going to see, you know, a lot of just powerful dancing and a really cool story that I'm sure a lot of people will be able to relate with. Okay. It seems like they're ready. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for being patient. Let's welcome K-12.
...of IGM and fellow families and friends. Tonight, I would like to tell you a story of Jeff. It begins with him, a cute little baby in a happy little family. They were happy until the fights began. Everything fell apart.
이제 저는 못하겠다.
뭘 더 못하겠다는 거야? 우리 결혼 15년, 난 당신 때문에 너무 힘들었다고. 내 아들 아니었으면 난 벌써 당신을 떠났다고. 알아?
네가 하는 게 뭔데? 넌 네 생각밖에 안 하잖아.
Well, that pretty much sums up his childhood. Now fast forward to where the real story begins. He grew up to be a handsome, talented young man, enjoying all the world has to offer. Hurry up, Jeff! Let's dance!
아, 대박. 난 연예인이 됐어야 돼. 저기요. 지금 클럽 안에서 나 노는 거 보고 나 따라 나온 거 아니야?
저요? 아니에요.
전 지금 저기 있는 교회에서 나오는 길이었어요. 근데 하나님이 좀 더 걸어가라는 감동을 주셔서 걷다 보니 여기까지 오게 됐어요.
예? 하나님이 무슨 클럽까지 걸어가라 말해요? 저기요. 교회에서 나 같은 남자 못 만나. 교회 분들 이런 거 할 수 있어?
저 그냥 갈게요.
Well, that was a disaster, Jeff thought to himself. Time to go home. Hope mom is already sleeping. Jeff quickly rushed home.
아들, 이리 와봐. 너 도대체 뭐하고 다니는 거야?
아, 진짜 관심 좀 꺼.
뭐라고? 네가 엄마를 알아? 이건 남편 복도 없어. 하나밖에 없는 자식이 저런.
아, 엄마. 아, 됐어, 됐어. 엄마하고는 대화가 안 돼 아주. 나 엄마 관심 필요 없고 나 내일 쇼핑 가야 되니까 저 테이블 위에다가 카드 두고 나가. 알았지?
알았어, 아들.
The next morning, Jeff grabbed his mom's credit card off the table and decided to go on a shopping spree at his favorite store, Gucci. Gucci, Gucci, Gucci. 돈 많은 척하는 애들은 저리 가. Yeah. 네 연봉을 내 어깨에 다 퍼니까. Yeah. I'm way too fly to be one of y'all. 내 위치에서 너 숨도 못 쉬어. 내가 왜 굳이 눈에 나간지 한 병 보낼게 형들이랑 마셔. 이 언니, 네 언니, 내 young boy. 저 돌아가는 길에 저기 왜 다 불러줘. Cause I'm self-made. Ain't nobody ever made me. I'm in a party going crazy.
Pretty woman walking down the street. Pretty woman, the kind I like to meet. Pretty woman, I don't believe you, you're not the truth. No one could look as good as you.
여긴 어쩐 일? 쇼핑하러 온 거야?
아, 안녕하세요.
근데 네가 구찌에서?
아, 전 원래 이런 데서 쇼핑 못 하는데요. 제가 6개월이나 열심히 일하고 저희 사모님께 구찌백 하나 선물해 드리려고 왔어요.
아, 뭐 갖고 싶은 거 있으면 골라봐. 오빠 하나 사줄게.
아, 아니에요.
이 여자의 정체가 도대체 뭐지? 내 멋있는 춤에도 관심이 없고 명품백도 마다하고. 잠깐만요, 그쪽이 다닌다는 교회 나도 따라가도 될까요?
아, 당연하죠. 이번 주 일요일에 꼭 오세요.
Jeff had just done something completely unexpected. Something stirred in his heart. And he decided to go to this IGM church that Sunday.
저기 지금 뭐 하시는 거예요?
안녕하세요. 저 기도하고 있었어요. 여기는 제가 저번에 구찌백 사드린 사모님이고요.
교회는 우리에게 꼭 필요한 곳이야. 우리가 예수님을 만나게 되면 네가 지금까지 살아왔던 괴로운 삶에서 나올 수 있게 될 거야. 같이 해보자.
Let's get down to business to defeat your sins. I'm never gonna catch my breath. Say goodbye to those who knew me. Was I fool for thinking I could win?
Someone's got scared to death, but she doesn't see right through me.
I really wish I knew how to pray. Must be swift with the Holy Spirit. His powerful as a price paid on the cross.
The quiet yet sure voice of God had moved Jeff to remember his mother. He knew she hated the church, but was determined to bring her anyway, for a church celebration was about to begin.
I just can't believe where my life was at. All that I know is my heart was broken.
broke and I don't ever wanna go back. Ain't no explanation how I saw the light. He found me and he set me free and he brought me back to life. You've got to shake, 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 shake like a chain, chain, chain.
Thank you so much, K-12. Ladies and gentlemen, what do you think? Do you think Dark Horse is an appropriate name for this group? I mean, that was pretty spectacular given, you know, K-12 hasn't done so well in the past. For our interviewees, could we have Mugyeong Jipsanim, could we have Nicole, and can we have Steve come up, please? Hello, mother. How are you feeling?
숨차요.
Job well done. Let's get a round of applause for Mugyeong and Steve. Can we also have Nicole up here? So Steve, you look like some young blood who brought some fresh talent. How long have you been dancing?
Korean or English? 춤은 이제 뭐 한 5년 정도. 옛날에 대학교 때 이제는 안 추고. 네.
저는 춤을 30년 췄는데요.
Yes, so Steve has been dancing for about 5 years since college, and my mother has been dancing for 30 years, and it clearly shows. What about you, Nicole? Are you an experienced dancer yourself?
Well, it's an unpopular fact, but I've been dancing since I was born.
So who came up with this idea of this storyline? Could you guys talk about that?
That is a secret. Jeff가 처음부터 끝까지 다 비디오 만들고 그 뭐죠? 그거 프로듀싱 하고 춤 배우고 가르치고 하는 것 때문에 울기도 많이 울었습니다. 아줌마들이 하도 못해 가지고.
So Steve, if I'm correct, you've choreographed a lot of the stuff and you've taught the dance. How did it feel to choreograph some of the dances and how was it teaching some of the older ladies how to dance?
춤 만드는 거는 일단 너무 재밌었고요. 그리고 집사님들이 이제 너무 잘 막 열심히 배우겠다는 그런 마인드라서 저는 되게 쉬웠어요. 재밌었고. So it was a lot of fun. Yeah.
So Nicole, in this performance, you play a really innocent church girl who's always doing the right thing and even buying a Gucci bag for Samonim. Do you think you're a little bit like that in real life?
I hope so.
So you guys have a lot of props this year. Who came up with all the dresses and all the fashion stuff, the Gucci bags? Who got all the materials and all the dress together?
저희 명화 집사님이 인터넷에서 찾는 걸 너무 잘 찾으시고 제가 오더를 되게 많이 했고 많은 투자를 했습니다. 그리고 만드는 건 다 같이 나눠서 만들었어요. 조이 집사님하고 크리스찬 집사님이 맛있는 거 많이 만들어 주셨고요.
And you guys did the Mulan song. I mean, it sounded pretty great, right? Whoever sang that must have sang it really well. Who sang that song?
니콜? William.
I feel like you guys have done a really good job this year. How do you feel about your performance? How do you feel about its placement? Do you feel confident in a top three performance?
Yes.
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 Steve, I think I saw you did this interesting windmill dance. You know how to break dance? You have experience in that? That didn't look like a little bit. That looked like a lot of bit. Oh, he has a little injury on his arm. You okay? Oh, okay. Okay, so it seems like K10 is just about ready to go. Thank you for joining us. You guys are ready to go. Let's give one more round of applause for K12. A lot of talent, a lot of preparation, a lot of hard work. I personally seen the K10 performance, and it is absolutely amazing. They're going to use really beautiful props. They have a very interesting story, so I hope that you guys are all ready for it. Without further ado, let's please welcome K10.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth.
Once there was a tree, and he loved the little boy. And every day, the boy would come, and he would gather his leaves and make them into crowns and play king of the forest. The boy would climb up his trunk and swing from his branches and eat apples. The boy would play hide and go seek with the tree. And they always had so much fun together. And when the boy was tired, he would sleep in his shade. And the boy loved the tree very much. And the tree was happy. But time went by, and the boy grew older. And the tree was often alone. And then one day, the boy came to the tree. And the tree said, "Come, boy. Come and climb up my trunk and swing from my branches and eat apples and play in my shade and be happy. I am too big to climb and play. I want to buy things and have fun. I want some money. Can you give me some money?" "I'm sorry," said the tree, "but I have no money. I have only leaves and apples. Take my apples, boy, and sell them in the city. Then you will have money, and you'll be happy." And so the boy climbed up the tree and gathered his apples and carried them away, and the tree was happy. The boy stayed away for a long time, and the tree was sad. And then one day, the boy came back, and the tree shook with joy. And he said, "Come, boy, come and climb up my trunk and swing from my branches and be happy. I am too busy to climb trees. I want a house to keep me warm. I want a wife and children. Can you give me a house?" "I have no house," The forest is my house. You may cut off my branches and trunk and build a house. Then you will be happy. And so the boy cut off his branches and carried them away to build his house. And the tree was happy. And the tree was lonely. And the boy stayed away for a long time.
Then it all went wrong. I dreamed a dream in time gone by, when hope was high and life worth living. I dreamed that love would never die. I dreamed that God would be forgiving.
Take this fainted heart. Take these tainted hands. Even when my strength is lost, I'll praise you. Even when I have no song, I'll praise you. Even when it's hard to find the words louder than I say your praise.
The tree was happy. The boy was happy. And the boy said, I am sorry. I am sorry, tree. You have given everything to me, but I have nothing left. I am no longer worthy to be called as your boy. Now, all I want is to be with you forever. Come, boy. You are still my boy. Come and sit down and rest on my stump. I will be with you forever. And the tree and the boy lived happily ever after.
Ah, 예, 감사합니다. 감사합니다. 멋진 공연 감사합니다. 근데 이거 누가 다 주실 거예요? 저희 우리 최희 지사님이랑 해나 지사님 앞으로 나와 주시겠어요?
You was told. 저희가 의자랑
저희가 지금 이거를 청소해야 되기 때문에 의자를 못 쓸 것 같아요. 잠시 서서 대화해도 괜찮을까요? 네, 그럼 옆으로 나와주시면은 오케이. 지사님 공연 너무 재밌게 잘 봤습니다. 영어로 그 스토리나 아웃라인 팀 이런 것들을 좀 설명해 주시겠어요? 저희에게 왜 이런 컨셉을 영어로
sucks because
God, he gives everything to us. So this is the giving tree. It's a story about how God, the tree gives everything to the boy. And at the end, what is that? He has nothing left but the tree. So, huh? Yeah, the, what is that? Freedom isn't free, so it takes work. His freedom is not free. Yeah. Yes. So, yeah. So let her explain it here. She does a better job. Here, go. Do it.
해람 씨가 더 잘 설명. 영어도 괜찮고 한국말도 괜찮을 것 같아요. 이제
기빙 트리를 한 게 이렇게 나무가 하나님이고 우리가 지금 이렇게 다 누리고 이렇게 자유를 가지고 살아갈 수 있는 게 그냥 주어진 것이 아니고 예수님이 희생이 있었기 때문에 우리가 지금 이렇게 크리스마스 퍼포먼스도 하지 않고 이렇게 자유를 누리면서 살아갈 수 있지 않나 해서 그런 의미로 준비했습니다.
보니까 모든 멤버분들이 초록색 옷을 직접 제작하신 것 같은데 이거를 뭐 어떻게 제작하게 되셨는지 스토리가 있나요? 이거에 대해서?
저희가 모든 사람들이 이렇게 자기의 시간과 열정을 다 희생해가지고 한 거거든요. 어떤 분들은 그 옷을 만드는 재주가 있으신 분들은 이렇게 정말 밤을 새면서 옷도 만들고 영상도 밤을 새면서 이렇게 만들고 모든 것을 그렇게 했어요. 그리고 예술성에 의미를 둔 자는 걸로.
죄송합니다. 오케이. No, we need more time because they need to set up too. 그러면은 저희 더위다 추운 것 같으니까 소파에 편하게 앉아서 대화할까요, 저희? 우리 셋업 팀께서 이거를 갖다 주실 것 같아요, 조만간. 네. 그리고
Thank you. Yes, if you can give us a time.
Can you tell us a little bit of Jonathan? Did you have to learn how to ride the swings for that show?
Yes.
How was riding the swing? When you first
Good.
Okay. So who built the swing? It was amazing. I mean, sure, it was short. But the swing idea.
The younger guys in our group, they built the swing. Julie Sunim and the other, ladies, they decorated the swing and stuff. So.
Do you think you can tell us a little bit about the idea behind the swing? Why it was there, why you guys made it, and what it represents?
처음에 이제 저희가 스윙을 한 게 그 영상을 보고 너무 이쁜 거예요. 아이들이 나와서 스윙을 타면서 이렇게 그네를 타면서 노래 부르는 게 너무 예뻐가지고 저게 진짜 순수하게 아이들이 이렇게 하나님의 자유를 누리면서 이렇게 노는 모습이 아닐까 해서 스윙을 제작하게 되었어요.
그러면은 이제 공연의 첫 부분이 스윙을 보여주면서 하나님 안에서 자유로운 모습. 그 다음에 그 거침없이 준 나무, 거침없이? 아니, 아낌없이 주는 나무는 하나님을 약간 상징하는 항상 저희에게 주시는 그런 거군요. 네. Nicole, do you have any question you want to ask for them?
그러면 who came up with all the choreography for the dances? 그러니까 안무 같은 거 누가 정하고 가르치고 하셨나요?
이렇게 안무, 이렇게 빠른 신나는 세상적인 안무는 우리 유스 그룹 아이들이 직접 준비하고 직접 만든 거거든요. 그리고 이렇게 기빙 트리는 아낌없이 주는 나무 이렇게 연극처럼 할 때는 지니 집사님과 제가 이렇게 준비를 했어요.
네, 감사합니다. 멋진 공연 너무 잘 봤고요. 다음 이번에 그러면은 뭐 How do you guys feel about placement? You guys think you guys made it this time?
No comment. I don't know. I hope so.
Well, thank you guys for coming out. It was a great show and we loved it. Can we get a round of applause for them one more time? Thank you. For us as we are prepping the stage will be E2. And as I mentioned before, they are one of the top contenders for the placement. And every year they do something amazing. Like I remember this one year, they had like 2,000 iPads and they were just going in and out, making shapes. This year, their performance I heard is called Diamond in the Rough. right?
So from what I know, they're doing a take on Aladdin, and instead of calling it Aladdin, they will be calling it Diamond in the Rough. And I'm sure that during their performance, they will talk more about what it means to be a diamond in the rough. So we will look forward to that.
상당히 많은 옷과 뭐 준비 이렇게 material and props 이런 게 너무 많아가지고 시간이 좀 걸리는 것 같은데 혹시 E2가 지금 몇 명이나 되죠? 거기에 거의 뭐 한 천 명 가까이 된다고 들었는데.
뭐 그렇게 저도 들었습니다. Yes, I did hear it was like that too.
아, 제가 사실 어제 리허설 때 잠깐 보긴 봤는데 그 다 쓰니까 무대가 살짝 떨어지더라고요. 사람이 너무 너무 많아가지고.
Can you ask them how much more time they need?
네. 그러면. Are you guys ready? 오케이 준비가 끝났다고 합니다. 그러면. 불 꺼주시고요. 저희 E2 Diamond in the Rough 뜨거운 박수로 맞이해 주시면 감사하겠습니다.
굿 이브닝 투 올 유 레이디즈 앤 젠틀맨. 웰컴 투 더 페이블드 시티 오브 아그라바. You've never been? Well, we can fix that.
Arabian Nights, like Arabian Days. They seem to excite, take off and take flight, to shock and amaze. Arabian Nights, neath Arabian moons. A fool off his guard,
it's a rough world where a hopeless nobody can be refined into a shining diamond.
Aladdin! I'll get you for this!
Rap, rap, street rap, scoundrel!
Take that, try a different tack, guys!
A hint, gotta face the facts. Could really use a friend or two. One jump ahead of the hook beats. One hop ahead of the hump. One trick ahead of disaster. They're quick, but I'm much faster. Here goes, better throw my hand and wish me happy landing. All I gotta do is pump.
Whoa. Give up. Not a chance. You can't get the girl. Who do you think you are, you little jashy? You're a nobody. That's all you'll ever be. No, you're no diamond in the rough.
Doodle.
Riff raff. Street rat. I don't buy that. If only they'd look closer, would they see a poor boy? No siree.
Downcast. Aladdin wanders into the desert and stumbles upon the Cave of Wonders.
This is the Cave of Wonders. Ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you.
Whoa! It's a magic carpet! And it can fly?
Wow. What's that?
Whoa.
Who are you? Are you a genie?
I'm not a genie. I'm Jesus.
You're a nobody. That's all you'll ever be.
Oh, you're Jesus? Well, I'm a nobody.
Look, Aladdin, when you've got a friend like me, you're not a nobody. You're a diamond in the rough.
Here I go! This the big part, watch out! This the big part, oh! Can your friends do this? Can your friends do that? Can your friends pull this?
little hack.
Can your friends go?
I'm the Jesus of the light. I can sing, rap, dance, if you give me a chance. Oh!
Mr.
Aladdin, yes.
One wish or two or three. Well, I'm on the job, you big nabob. You ain't never had a friend, never had a friend. You ain't never had a friend, never had a friend. You ain't never,
never
had a friend. You ain't never had a friend like me.
But Jesus, look at me. I'm still just a street rat.
No, Aladdin, stop looking at your old self because I died to make you a new creation, a son of God, living in a whole new world.
A whole new world, 100,000 things to see. Now your beloved son, I've come so far.
Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away, and see, the new has come.
It's a rough world, where a hopeless nobody can be refined to a shining diamond.
Brandon and Mina, can you guys stay a little bit before you guys go down? Can you guys come here? First of all, what a performance. Wow. That was almost like Broadway. That was so good. Oh, come to the center. Come to the center. Now, these costumes, were they made or were they ordered?
That's a secret.
But you've already performed. You can't tell us a little bit about your costumes?
It's a secret.
Okay, then what about the performances? Now, choreography was great. We had a lot of people doing the same choreography, but just different enough to show this ripple effect. Who was in charge of coming up with all this choreography? Can you tell me a little bit about, you know, how, what motivated you to do certain choreography and moves?
What motivated me was... At the same time, I had to think about, I had to be mindful of who is dancing and how many are dancing, and so, and how much space we have. And with this number amount of people, we can't do too much dancing, so we had to go with more of a picturesque or of something that'll make a picture, pretty much.
Oh, so instead of intensive dancing, you did the picturesque kind of dances on purpose to make it look better with so many people. Now, that was a great show. I would pay to watch this show, I think. Okay. Do you guys want to talk about the story of the Aladdin, how you fused the Aladdin concept with the following of Jesus? Can you talk about that?
When we do IGL, I don't know how many of you guys know, but we typically do, like, on the first day, a nickname for the person that's next to you. And two of our group members, Robert, who actually passed away recently, and then Justin Oppa, they were sitting next to each other, and Uncle Robert, he said, "Justin, you're like a diamond in the rough. Your past is rough, and like everyone else, like, we're broken. But he had a diamond on his, like, a diamond tattoo on his sleeve, and he said, but you're also a diamond because you're found in God. And I heard that at IGL, and it really stuck with me because I realized, well, that's everyone's story. Everyone is broken. We all come from a broken past. And like someone says, we can say, like, you're more broken than me, I'm less broken, but the end result is we're broken. And I really wanted to capture that we were broken, but when we were found by Jesus, we really became this precious, like, we're so precious to God that he would give, you know, his one and only son to us. And we really wanted to capture that. And we just thought it was so perfect that magic carpet helps Aladdin find the lamp in the movie. And so we said, well, the magic carpet is like Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit guides us to draw closer to Jesus. And so, yeah, that's pretty much it.
Well, that was an amazing performance. Thank you guys for coming up here. I think they need the stage for the next setup. Thank you. I haven't had a chance to really interview them, but I'm sure they have something amazing in store for us, and I think they're prepping right now. So while we wait for them to, you know, do a little setup, I wanted to talk about maybe my experiences as I was prepping for the Christmas performance. It was a lot of dancing, intense dances, actually, because we have very few number of people. And we also wanted to incorporate a story. And why? Why are we doing this? Now, at first when I started, it was very like, do I have to put all this work and effort into a performance that's going to be shown for maybe 7 minutes in front of people that we kind of know, you know? Spending every night from like 8 to midnight or all over weekends just at church, church, church. The last 3 weekends for me, I was at church longer than I was at home. So it was like, but then looking back now and, you know, like the experience, the fights, the laughter and the passion that we put into this effort, I feel like if I didn't do this, on a Christmas, I'll be out there doing something else. Like with my friends, I'll be, you know, going driving up to LA or meeting my friends to do some other stuff. And I know it's funny now, but looking back, I actually had to say, hey guys, I can't come out today because I have to do a performance for my church. And my friends were like, Jeff, you've been doing it for 3 weeks. Like, what are you doing with your life? And for the first time, I said, I like doing this. And I feel like maybe there's something here, so I'm going to do this. You guys play. And it felt good to say that. And, you know, we made this great performance for everyone. And I'm very proud of not only our group, but all of you guys spending all that time and energy, you know, coming up and preparing for this performance. Okay? I think the next group is ready to go now. Okay? Okay, let me introduce you guys to K9. 저희 다음 그룹은 K9 그룹인데 저희 뜨거운 박수로 맞이해 주시면 감사하겠습니다.
Make it, 알아맞혀봐. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 이거 네 글자로 고쳐봐, 먹게. 연구 없다.
여기 있네, 여기 있네, 여기 있네, 여기 있네. 들어가, 알라. 들어가.
선생님 오셨군요.
오드라! 어머, 어머, 어머. 쏘리, 쏘리. 얘들아, 차렷! 선생님께 경례!
안녕하세요. 자, 여러분, 오늘은 우리가 지저스하고 사랑에 대해서 공부할 거예요. 네. 그 전에 우리 IGM 담임 목사님 성함을 잘 모르는 것 같아요. 아시는 분? 자, 신입생 한번 해봐요.
승철.
누구든지 알았어? 누구든지 알았어?
이승철.
우리 목사님 성함은 신. 천재가 승. 훈이야.
꼭 하나씩 부족해.
아니야. 네 나랑 비슷한 것 같다 야. 선생님. 저는 우리 목사님 이름 영어를 알아요.
아, 너는 한국말도 잘 못하잖아.
잘 들어. 제 우스신이야.
영구야, 왜 제임스 딘이라고 그러지?
자, 우리 담임 목사님 성함은 다음 시간까지 숙제예요. 네. 자, 이번에는 우리 예수님에 대해서 아시는 분?
저요, 저요, 선생님.
저요, 저요. 너 안 시키면 큰일 나겠다.
선생님, 그분은요, 제가 잘 알아요. 머리 풀고요. 맨발로 다니시는 그런 분이에요. 맞지?
아닌데 아닌데 그분 우리 사돈인데.
아니 예수님하고 언제 사돈 맺으셨나?
우리 며느리가 새벽마다 기도할 때 아버지 아버지 하더라니까.
훌륭한 며느리님을 두셨군요. 그만 두드리고 환자 제대로 좀 설명해봐. 예수님이 누구신지.
주는?
주는?
그리스도시오?
그리스도시오?
살아계신 하나님의 아들이시니다.
잘 들으셨죠?
네.
이번에는 우리 사랑에 대해서 네 가지 아시는 분?
저요! 저요!
해봐요. 이거 마이크 들고.
선생님, 저는 제 짝꿍 글로리아가 잘 됐으면 좋겠어요.
그렇죠.
사랑해.
사랑은요, 저같이 있는 그대로 하는 거예요.
네, 맞습니다. 있는 그대로.
어려워, 너무. 저요.
자신 있게, 자신 있게.
끝까지.
나와보라고.
자, 우리 네 가지 사랑 잘 기억하고 마지막으로 합창을 하고 끝내도록 해요.
싸우지라 최악보수 형제들아
영광
담대하게 싸우지라 저기 악한 첩병들과
영광
심판날과 멸망의 날 내가 섰는 눈앞에 곧 다가오리라 곧 다가오리라 최악 보스 형제들아
영광
조합치는 무리들은 흉함하게 아니던가
영광
무섭고도 더러운 죄 모두 떨쳐버리고 주 예수 붙들라 주 예수 붙들라
Thank you very much. That was a very interesting and funny and spectacular performance. What do you think, Jeff?
근데 많은 개그들이 완전 좀 한국 스타일인데 울리엄 이해할 수 있었어요?
Well, I'm native, so I don't speak Korean.
아, 근데 그 목사님 성함을 가지고 재밌는 스토리들 막 개그 이렇게 하시는 게 너무 재밌고 진짜 좀 새로운 경험이었던 것 같습니다.
It was a very interesting and new experience for our Christmas performance.
Yep. 어, can we 우리 연구 하신 분 황 집사님 잠시 올라와 주시겠어요?
잘 생겼네.
아, 왜 되는 게 소리? Okay, 너무 너무 재밌었어요. 특히 처음에 뒤로 있으셨다가 갑자기 탁 도셨을 때 진짜 배꼽이 튀어 나오는 줄 알았어요. 너무 웃겨서 한번 그 1부터 8까지는 뭔지 한 번 더 말씀해 주시겠어요?
예, 이제 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10을 네 글자로 줄이면 이제 그게 영구 없다가 되는 거죠. 그래서 이제 그 패러디로 하게 된 겁니다.
아, 그렇게 말고 재밌게.
아, 재밌게. 얘들아, 얘들아. 내가 재밌는 퀴즈 낼게. 맞춰 봐. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. 이거 네 글자로 고침 뭐게? 영구 없다.
이 크리스마스 퍼포먼스를 준비하실 때 너무너무 재밌었을 것 같아요.
아, 정말 우리 예. K9은 예. 진짜 매번 할 때마다 너무 기쁘고 너무 즐겁게 저 이 준비를 했던 것 같아요. 저 우리 잘 아시겠지만 K9의 컨셉이 이 우리 모든 그 IGM 식구들을 좀 즐겁게 하자. 그런 컨셉을 해서 계속해서 나가고 있습니다.
그러면은 이렇게 항상 즐겁고 행복한 시간을 보내면서 크리스마스 퍼포먼스를 준비하시는데 우리 다른 그룹들은 가끔씩 싸우는 그룹도 있고 뭐 힘들어하는 그룹도 많은데 그 그룹들에게 좀 충고 한마디만 해주시겠다면
연구하면 됩니다. 연구하면 연구하시면 돼요.
네, 멋진 공연 감사합니다.
감사합니다. 감사합니다.
조심히 들어가세요.
We need to make a quick administrative announcement. For our next performance, we need the walkways clear. So our younger members, if we can leave these walkways clear, this one as well as that.
God이라고 합니다. 하나님께서 저희를 먼저 사랑을 주셨으니 우리도 하나님께 사랑을 돌려드려야 된다. 해가지고 이 그룹이 단체로 한 번도 못 해본 거를 다 같이 배워서 멋진 공연을 준비했다고 합니다.
The title of this performance is called From God to God, and it's talking about what we receive from God and how we are to respond to God. Now, we learned that in preparing for this performance, they picked up a unique skill that none of them knew how to do, but they learned it together, and they learned it pretty well, if you ask me.
Are you guys ready? 그 지금 준비가 저 옆에 자리 다 치워 주셨죠? 준비가 되신 것 같은데.
So Jeff, how do you feel about the performances so far? The night is going long, but it's been filled with great performances, don't you think?
솔직히 말씀드리면은 제가 그 2부 쇼 중에서 거의 한 네 쇼는 못 본 것 같아요. 네, Victor Santos and J Group, 그 다음에 K-10 거를 못 보긴 했는데 제가 들어오자마자 딱 본 게 E2 그룹이었는데 너무 깜짝 놀랐어요. 네, 그 막 공연 옷에 준비에 그 스토리까지 너무 재밌게 보고 있습니다. 그리고 뭐 다른 그룹들도 너무 특별한 게 자기만의 것을 색깔을 보여주는 것 같아서 아직까지도 다른 그룹들이 뭘 해주실지 기대가 아직 많습니다. 네.
I agree. There's been really cool and heartwarming and funny performances so far. You know, E2 was good, but I got to witness K-12, and K-12 was really something to see. The progression over the years has been really cool. Now, we only have, I think, 3 more performances left. So we ask that you hang in there. I'm sorry, 2 more performances left. We ask that you hang in there and you have a nice, relaxed time, but still be intent for what's to come.
아, 너무 아쉽지만 이제 공연이 두 개밖에 안 남았다고 합니다. 이 공연이 끝나면은 저희가 마지막 공연을 시작할 거니까 조금 불편하시더라도 힘을 내시고 조금만 기다려주시고 더 열정 있게 치열해 주시면 감사하겠습니다.
So let me ask one more time, now that Jeff is here, who is a better MC? If you like Jeff, please applause. Thank you. Now if you like Will, please applause.
Woo! 이거 왜 하는지 모르겠어. 자기가 이길 줄 알고.
You've been a great co-host so far, and you know, in the moments of setting up, in the moments of technical difficulties, it can be difficult to keep the conversation going and to capture the attention of the audience. So I appreciate you coming up here with me and co-hosting for the Late Late Show. I know you didn't have to. So one more time, can we get a round of applause for Jeff? Ladies and gentlemen, I think I made one misannouncement earlier before the intermission. I said that we'll be selling the cookies during intermission, but I was misinformed by Guillermo. So we're actually going to be selling them after the performance. So please stay, please help out.
네, 다음 그룹이 준비가 끝났다고 합니다. 다들 그 K8 From God to God. 뜨거운 박수로 맞이해 주시면 감사하겠습니다.
Silent night, ooh. 안녕하세요. K8 우클렐레 합주단입니다. 저희 연주를 통해서 하나님께 큰 영광 돌리기를 기원합니다. 그리고 저희들이 상을 받을 수 있다면 하나님께 더 큰 영광이 되실 줄 믿습니다. 네, 모든 심사위원님들이 아멘으로 화답해 주셨습니다. 감사합니다.
주님의 사랑
복여름 걸고
나를 지켜주네.
이젠 혼자 걷지 않아.
그 어떤 시련도
이젠 두렵지 않아.
내가 넘지 못할 산
이젠 존재치 않아.
그 어떤 시련도
이젠 두렵지 않아.
내가 넘지 못할 산
이젠 존재치 않아.
세상 것들을 let go, 우리 모두 let's go. 오른발 왼발 한 발 한 보 앞으로 어디로
주님의 나라로
어디로
주님의 나라로
my faith. I'm yours.
네, 감사합니다. 멋진 공연. 거기 다 들어가지 마시고 저희 몇 분만 좀 남아서 저 인터뷰 좀 해주실 수 있으실까요? 윌리엄 씨, 방금 본 공연 어땠어요?
You know, as a professional musician myself, who has performed worldwide in the Carnegie Hall as a soloist, I have to say that the music was actually pretty impressive, wouldn't you agree? It was pretty good. I like how they employed the different styles of, you know, reggae and, you know, whatever else they put up there. It was awesome to see.
Hambusan 집사님께서 저한테 무슨 일이 있어도 자기는 부르지 말라고 그래서 불렀어요. 자, 저희 시작하기 전에 그 제가 듣기로는 유쿨레일리를 지금 다 공연을 하셨잖아요. 근데 시작 이 퍼포먼스 하기 전에 아무도 할 줄 몰랐다고 그거에 대해서 좀 얘기해 주시겠어요?
아, 네, 저희 15명이 퍼포먼스했는데 처음으로 다 유클렐레를 배웠어요. 그래서 다 같이 처음 배우고 또 집사님들은 유클렐레만 처음 배우신 게 아니라 사실 악기를 처음 해보신 거세요. 그래서 되게 연습을 많이 하신 것 같아요.
그럼 어떤 부분이 제일 힘들었고 누가 제일 말썽을 피웠어요?
아, 집사님.
그리고 한부선 집사님 말씀하실 땐 레게이 스타일로 말씀해 주시세요. 아까 랩한 것처럼
어떻게 해야 될지 제일 힘든 사람은 아마 저였을 것 같아요. 근데 이번에 제가 참 악기도 처음 하고 이것도 처음 하면서 너무 재미있었고 그리고 제가 진짜 하나님을 만나지 않았으면 누가 저한테 이런 걸 시키지도 않았을 거고 저도 이런 걸 절대 안 했을 거고 너무 감사했어요 사실은.
그러면은 이게 다 같이 모여서 공연할 때 좀 힘든 점도 있었을 거고 웃긴 일도 있었을 텐데 그 경험이 어땠는지 한 소감만 말씀해 주실 수 있으세요? 힘든 점이나 뭐 웃긴 거나 스토리가 있으시면
모든 그룹이 그렇겠지만 I'm pretty sure all the groups feel the same way but it's about making that time, you know, like everybody gathering. I mean, that was super difficult. And you know, people are tired after work, you know, and then you want to gather and practice, but sometimes, you know, you kind of like You get kind of frustrated from time to time. I'm not gonna lie. I was super frustrated so many times during the practice. But like, I don't know, like just watching the performance again today, I'm just kind of realizing like, why am I doing this, right? And then like, I just like thought about the lyrics I wrote, you know, the song that we sang, and I'm like, man, where would I be without God? And then, you know, just capturing my thought back. And then I think that's how everybody is, every group is, you know, sometimes there's like rough times, good times, and then when people are on the same page, everybody just like, okay, let's just do it for God. I think that's when like that kind of joy overflows even within the practice. And then especially when you're performing, you know, everybody that were performing earlier, like I could just see joy in their faces, right? I'm pretty sure they had tough times, but performing, I'm sure like they enjoyed it. So, yeah.
아, 감사합니다. 힘든 점도 많았지만 overall 행복했다고 말씀해 주셨습니다. 지금까지 인터뷰 봐 주셔서 감사하고요. 멋진 공연 감사합니다.
네.
Group is unfortunately or fortunately the final group of the evening. It's going to be E1. Now, I know you guys have been sitting there for a long time. You guys are getting antsy, but we ask that you be patient and sit through and enjoy one more performance. Jeff, we saw the E1 performance together. What are some thoughts without giving anything away?
아무것도 유출하지 않고 생각이 어떠냐고 물어보시면 일단 제가 봤을 때 재밌어요. 재밌고
yeah, it's just a lot of fun.
진짜 이 그룹만이 할 수 있는 거다 이거는. 다른 그룹은 못 한다. 이 생각도 들었고 마지막으로 역시 그 우리 마이크 집사님의 유머는 진짜 너무너무 웃긴 것 같아요. 네.
Yeah, I agree. This is a kind of performance that only E1 can carry out and can pull off. And like you said, you know, Mike Chipsanim, he has a very special kind of humor that just makes everybody laugh. And I'm sure all of you guys will be laughing tonight. Are you excited for this performance?
전 너무너무 기대됩니다. 제가 보다가 잘렸었는데 처음부터 끝까지는 솔직히 못 봤어요. 저희가 이제 저희가 본 이유는 그 뭘 여쭤볼지 뭐 노트를 써야 될 게 있을지 뭐 이런 것 때문에 잠깐씩 봤는데 끝까지 아직 못 봐서 엔딩까지 어떻게 잘 이렇게 끝내시는지 너무너무 궁금합니다.
네.
Now, I really appreciate you being my co-host. Now that we're to our final act and our show is about to close, how do you feel? Do you feel a little sad but happy? What are you feeling tonight?
아, 솔직히 말씀드리면은 여기 서 있는 동안 계속 떨어가지고 시간 가는지 몰랐어요. 근데 제가 이제 말을 하다가 이제 턱 막힐 때가 있는데 제가 턱 막힐 때 울리엄 이렇게 툭툭 치고 say something, say something 이러면은 이럴 때마다 울리엄이 딱 저를 커버해주고 잘 이끌어줘서 저는 오히려 편하게 처음부터 끝까지 진행을 할 수 있었었던 것 같습니다.
Yeah, translation. He said that I'm the best MC that ever was. Now I see there's going to be some ridiculous costumes going on. I want every one of you to look out for them. It's going to be incredible. It'll be amazing. And you'll see, as you can tell, they're already creating a beautiful background. And you guys are going to love this performance.
William, Shark Tank가 뭔지 아세요, 근데?
Shark Tank is a kind of show where you present a business idea. And the sharks, the business investors, decide whether they like your idea and they want you. And they'll invest into your business or your company.
그렇죠. 이거를 잘 모르시는 분들도 계실 것 같아서 간단하게 설명드리자면은 Shark Tank라는 진짜 쇼가 있기는 있는데 이게 뭐냐면은 투자자들이 앉아가지고 그 사람이 와가지고 아이디어를 내면은 이 아이디어에가 내가 투자를 하겠다 안 하겠다를 보여주는 TV 프로그램입니다. 근데 그거를 약간 이렇게 트위스트를 해가지고 저희 교회에 맞는 퍼포먼스로 준비를 해주셨다고 합니다.
Okay, without further ado, it brings me great joy and sadness to introduce the last group of the evening, E1.
뜨거운 박수로 맞이해 주세요.
Who are the sharks? Mickey O'Leary is a shrewd, self-made billionaire who made his fortune following his dream that one day cannabis would be legalized. In only the last 2 years, he made a cool $900 million and is looking to become the fastest billionaire in the history of the world. Cindy Kim, on her 45th birthday, purchased a $1 lotto ticket that hit the biggest lotto jackpot in the history of the United States, cashing in a whopping $2 billion after taxes. She purchased the entire Rodeo Drive in Beverly Hills, spending 99% of her winnings. Danny Kim, the owner of the Los Angeles Lakers, turned the organization into one of the NBA's most famous and successful franchises after taking over the Lakers from Dr. Jerry Buss. His team is estimated to be worth over $10 billion. Cindy Ornelas, renowned billionaire cosmetics mogul and the founder and owner of Mary Kay Cosmetics. She built her cosmetics empire to over 100 countries worldwide. She is estimated to be worth over $10 billion. First in the tank are young entrepreneurs who believe in the no mercy style of martial arts, where their business motto is motivated when they heard the term, kick the man when he's down.
Hello, Sharks. My name is Marcus. I'm the founder and owner of No Mercy Taekwondo. Today, me and my students will be seeking an investment of $10 million for a 2% stake in our company. No Mercy Taekwondo only focuses on important punches and kicks. I mean, let's face it, one wants to wait 4 to 5 years to earn their black belt. As you guys can see, I have my own black belt right here. Now my students will demonstrate.
Those boys are good. That was amazing. Those boys are good.
How many schools do you have and how much money are you making right now?
Well, none right now. That's why we're here.
These boys are so cute! I just love them! But I'm out.
You mean you're making no money at this point? You're dead to me. I'm out.
I'm sorry, boys. This is too risky for me. I'm out.
You know what? I like it. But you boys don't know what you're doing. So I'll give you the $10 million, but I want 95% of your company. Do we got a deal?
I'll tell you what. Throw in some Lakers season tickets and courtside edition seats. And can we have a sleepover with LeBron?
You got a deal.
Next up is the Pho Noodle restaurant owner who sold his 25-year-old business to start the new fragrance line and dreams that one day everyone will smell like pho.
It's your lucky day for you, shots. My name is Mike. I'm seeking $5 million for 2% stake of my company.
I've got a bad feeling about this guy.
You had your pho company for 25 years?
That's right.
What was the name of your company?
It's called What the Pho.
I like it. But why did you sell your store?
For not 25 years, I've been working every day, so hard. No vacation, no graduation for my kids. And one day, I saw the sign. It says, What the Pho? I cannot live like this every day. But I like the smell of my pho so much. I need to smell it. What to do?
Okay, Long Duck Dong. I like your pho story, but get to the point. How do we make money?
That's why I made a cologne that smells like pho every day. It's called Pho Love.
You mean you copied Ralph Lauren Polo?
No, stupid. Not Polo. Follow.
That is such a brilliant idea. But I'm out.
What does it smell like? Can we smell it?
Why would you want to smell it?
Ladies, it's made out of 100% garlic. Onion and cilantro for Koreans.
Oh, this is horrible. You're crazy thinking anyone will invest in that. I'm out.
What
did you say?
I have no idea.
Man, this stuff smells nasty. You're crazy. Is that all you got?
That's why I have one more product. It's called Febreze. It's for my home. You can smell like pho every day, everywhere you go. Oh, wonderful. It's for you, Mr. Wonderful.
Do you have a name for your fragrance company? Could it be What the Pho?
No, absolutely not. My Christian friend told me it's not a good name. That's why I came up with a new name. It's called My Pho. It's so good. I even came up with a song. My pho is so good. Come on, ladies. My pho is so good.
This guy's crazy.
Everybody.
Security, get this guy out of here. This guy's crazy.
Come on,
Batherson.
I know it's your favorite song.
Oh, my goodness. This guy's crazy.
Last in the tank are two Christian sisters giving an offer that can change the lives of sharks in this world and in eternity.
My name is Kim.
Hi, my name is Jessie.
We're here today to offer you a chance to meet Jesus.
Woo! Woo!
And as a bonus, you will receive peace, joy, and earth.
You know, I already have a boatload of money and all the peace and joy I can handle. So what are you here for if not my money?
There's more to life than wealth, power, and fame.
Oh, blasphemy.
Life here on Earth is so short. What we have to offer you today is worth so much more. We don't want your money. We want you to commit your life to Jesus.
Well, how do you commit your life to Jesus? Can you tell us more about this?
Jesus is the way, the truth, and life. Would you like to meet Jesus?
No. It's okay. I'm out.
Wait. I think you should hear them out.
I'm back in.
Okay, so if not our money, what are you here for?
We're here to invite you to have an encounter with Jesus.
What do you mean? Are we really going to meet Jesus? And how are we going to meet him?
If you follow us, we could show you the way.
And what if I don't want to follow you? What if I don't want to believe in this Jesus?
Then you go to hell.
Hell? Oh, hell no. Come on, guys. You got to follow them. Let's go. You need it the most. Come on.
Thank you very much, Ewan, for that very funny, very funny performance. We'd like to invite Mickey and Mike and Danny to come up and be our interviewees for tonight. They'll be our last interviewees. I know it's sad, but it had to come at some point. Welcome. Jeff, what's not the most funny performance you've ever seen in your life?
I think this one.
So, who came up with the idea to do this Shark Tank concept?
I think we all just came up with it.
And why? Why the Shark Tank? Why did you choose that for this year?
We just didn't want to dance.
By the way, who did the narration? It sounds just like the show.
That was actually Kim's boyfriend.
Oh, yeah. Really? Uh-huh. Wow. Now, who came up with the idea to do the pho stuff? Uncle Mike, was that you?
No, it was him.
Really? That sounds like your kind of comedy.
아이디어는 집사님 내셨지만 마이크 집사님이 확실히 살리신 것 같아요. 진짜 너무 너무 재밌었어요. 네, 마이크 집사님은 근데 항상 이렇게 웃기세요? 세상 그냥 다니실 때도?
나보다 지금 웃긴 놈이라 그러는 거야.
저 언컬 맥이
항상 웃기진 않습니다.
Uncle Mickey, you play a very peculiar character in this role. Could you talk about that character?
You know, I've never watched Shark Tank. You know, this was my first introduction to Shark Tank. They told me to go watch a bunch of them. And Kevin O'Leary, the person that I'm kind of mimicking here, was a very sarcastic, I guess, person, which fit me pretty good. I figured, you know, sarcasm, I speak sarcasm.
And the taekwondo. Whose idea was it to do the karate, or was it the no mercy taekwondo? Who came up with that?
I think we all did. We all did. We wanted to involve the kids, and we knew Caleb, Noah, Elijah, they were very talented with taekwondo. So.
Yes. No one seems to want to take the blame here.
So it was a very collaborative effort then. Okay, that's really cool. And you guys feel like you guys gotten closer, perhaps, through this time together and the planning?
Oh, we planned it for a while. We got together and I think we spent about 95% of the time just eating. But, I mean, rest of the time, we met for a long time, we talked about it. But didn't involve too much practice, but we met for this for many times.
Okay, and I have one final question. Where can I get the Folo cologne?
We actually ordered that bottle. And I think Kim actually drew something, the noodle, the bowl in there. So, yeah.
Okay, any final thoughts?
Us being performing as a last group, I think it was just kind of a little anxious because you usually go in the front. But it was great seeing everybody giving glory to God and putting their efforts together. And our MCs were awesome, right? Our MCs, wow. That was fantastic emceeing, and I think so many groups did so well. So I'm glad that we had fun. And, yeah. Okay.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
감사합니다.
IGM Kids are about to put on a show that you won't want to miss. Jeff, are you excited about that?
네, 저희 IGM 그룹에 있는 우리 어린 아이들이 공연을 또 마지막 공연을 준비했다고 합니다. 네, 너무 너무 보고 싶어서 지금 저기. 보고 싶어요.
They're going to be cute. They're going to be adorable. I don't know what they're planning, and I bet it's going to be awesome. Are you kids ready?
Yes.
Yes? Please welcome the kids, the children of IGM.
주 사랑으로 가득할 때까지 나를 구원하신 주님의 은혜 나를 선택하신 주님의 계획 내게 주신 주님의 말씀 가서 주의 복음을 전하라 Go, go, go 기쁨으로 달려가니 온 세상 주의 복음 들을 때까지 Go, go, go 기쁨으로 전하니라 온 세상 주 사랑으로 가득할 때까지 나를 구원하신 주님의 은혜 나를 선택하신 주님의 계획 내게 주신 주님의 말씀 가서 주의 복음을 전하라 세상 주의 복음 들을 때까지 Go, go, go 기쁨으로 전하리라 온 세상 주 사랑으로 가득할 때까지 세상 주의 복음 들을 때까지 Go, go, go 기쁨으로 전하리라 온 세상 주 사랑으로 가득할 때까지 온 세상 주 사랑으로 가득할 때까지
That was quite incredible. It's really cool to see kids so young coming together and practicing. That was pretty cool, right, Jeff? Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you for joining us on this very special edition of the Late Late Show. I apologize we lost the couch somewhere along the way, but we're up here now. Jeff, I want to thank you personally for co-hosting with me. I couldn't have done it by myself. Let's give a warm round of applause for Jeff.
감사합니다.
Hey, 뭐 박수 치는 거 이거 할 거면은 우리 윌리엄도 받아야 될 것 같아요. 지금까지 저희 공연을 진짜 매끄럽게 너무 잘 이끌어준 윌리엄에게도 박수를 쳐주셨으면 감사하겠습니다. 그리고 믿을 수 있을지 모르시겠지만 저랑 윌리엄이랑 형제예요. We're brothers. 모르셨구나. 네, 그래서 저희를 진짜 어렸을 때부터 와 열심히 열심히 키워주시고 네, 너무 서포트 해주시고 우리 가족의 요셉 같으신 저희 어머님께도 큰 박수를 부탁드립니다.
For my mama!
<웃음> 또 한 가지는 저희가 MC를 볼 수 있었을 MC를 보는 걸 가능하게 해주신 우리 기에르모 어디죠?
기에르모, 기에르모, 기에르모.
그리고 저를 저를 도와준 니콜. 니콜 덕분에 저희가 너무 좋습니다. 마지막으로 이 모든 것을 가능하게 해주신 그리고 항상 저희를 사랑과 지혜로 이끌어주시는 우리 신 목사님, 지금 자리에 안 계시지만 그래도 안 계시지만 들릴 수 있게 큰 뜨거운 박수로.
Yes, let's give a round of applause for Pastor Shin.
목사님.
So this is the fun part of the night where they're tallying up all the scores of the performances. They're going to add it up and they're about to announce it. And this is going to be the anxiety ridden and we're going to be scared, but I ask that the winners accept it with grace and the losers accept also with grace. Unfortunately, there's only first, second, third, and fourth, and fifth for K-12 last year. I want to thank the audience, all of you guys, for putting up with these great MCs, Jeff and I. I just want to give a round of applause for yourselves. Can we do that? Let's do that.
네, 여기 앉아서 끝까지 관람해 주신 여러분들께도 감사합니다. 네.
Can we also get a round of applause for our back booth team, a sound team, lighting, media team? I don't know if you guys know, but they were here yesterday for 14 hours plus, making sure every single group got at least an hour to practice.
그것뿐만이 아니라 그 14시간이 끝나고도 제임스 집사님은 끝까지 나와서 교회 다 청소하고 가셨어요. 한두 시간을 더 남으셔서. 와, 진짜 제임스 집사님의 그 리더 할 자격이 충분하다 전 생각합니다.
Yes, we have determined that James is an acceptable leader because he has stayed afterwards to clean up the church. Another team that we'd like to celebrate that's not so well known is the setup team of carrying the couch up and down for every performance, of making sure every team is ready. Let's give it up for the setup team. Ladies and gentlemen, during intermission, because I played a joke on you that there was nothing under your seats, it felt kind of bad. So for real this time, there's a little gift for every single one of you under your seats. Go ahead and take a look. Ah, you guys fell for it again. I apologize.
지금 목사님께서 옆방에서 그 한 그룹 한 그룹 아 돌아오셨네요 지금. I think they have the final scores.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment of truth. Thank you for joining us on the Late Late Show. Good night, America.
Good night.
Let's give them a big hand. Thank you.